Two schools that in some ways carry a common heritage. Michigan State and Penn State in the battle for the Land Grant Trophy. That's going to do it here in the studio, but don't worry, we'll be keeping your finger on the pulse of everything that's going on everywhere else across the country. But right now, it's time for kickoff, and ESPN's College Football, Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit are on the call.
East Lansing, Michigan at Spartan Stadium, the battleground for this college football encounter. Fired up down there as they get ready to boot this opening kickoff. Brown fields it at the one. And down he goes at the 27. 6 yards. Zips it to the back. He's got an opening. Down the sideline. He's tackled number at the 18-yard line.
With the catch. That's good for a gain of 55 yards.
That's just a well-executed screen pass. They had the blockers in front, and they got it to him with room to run.
Be a factor here on third and short. Day takes the give. Touchdown, Nittany Lions. He got the handoff and knew exactly what to do with it.
They like the fact that they have a halfback who can pick.
Bell on the give. Brought down at the 24-yard line.
Did you see how much space there was for that tailback up front? He better be thanking his offensive lineman for that. He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it to make a catch.
Backward pass, that's a fumble. And he is drilled at the 48. That's a pretty big mistake, and this offense will lose possession of the football.
Sloppy job by the ball carrier. First and foremost, you should always be concerned about the ball.
Tough break for the offense. They lose it on a backward pass. Drops back to pass. Over the middle, got his tight end. Touchdown, Penn State! They let the tight end get so open on such a big play.
That was poor defense. Looks like there was some miscommunication between the safety and the linebackers, which caused for him to get so open. That receiver was so wide.
Tackle made around the 37-yard line.
Not sure about that play call as they fail on fourth.
First down, looking to throw. He scrambles. Caught, and that's her first down. Brought down at the 42-yard line.
Guys, I really like what the offensive coordinator is doing here. Throwing it on first and second down will keep the defense guessing.
Here he goes. He's at the 30. Oh, so close to breaking it.
Call it a gain of 23 yards. First down.
I like how efficient the offense looked on that play. Everybody knew their assignment, and it all came together for a nice run.
The five, and he hauls that one in. Throws, and he's hit immediately.
It's time for the defense to switch something around because they've gotten eaten up on these last.
Hit on the throw, he caught it. The 50, and he's tackled right around the 34.
This is a great pitch and catch combination, and they hook up here for a big time gain.
Pumps once, fires quickly, and it's picked off.
Brad, not only a huge interception to get the football back, but maybe have a chance to get back into this game, but this could really change momentum. You can see the players and how they're responding down there on the sideline about how excited they are.
On the run, touchdown,
Great job of finding the space to run and just bursting in for six.
But I don't think too many people were expecting this. Penn State's in front by 11.
They'll work the left side. He's at midfield. Brought down.
Right around the 48-yard line.
First down here, Brad, by this offense. The receiver's running the football. You got to think as a defense.
Maxwell drops back. He's got all day. He heaves it deep.
And he lays out for that one. Field with five wideouts.
Quick toss.
Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown.
And did that play ever develop nicely?
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that.
Scrambling around. He rolls left.
They bring him down.
A defensive end with this kind of speed is an offensive worst nightmare. He's got the ability.
He drops back. Catches it. He's at the 20. Tackle made.
And this is nothing more than a chip shot.
Kicks away. And they tack on 3 points.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
He's back to pass here on first down. Throws in a hurry.
It's a great job here by the quarterback of recognizing the outside linebacker blitz and delivering the football for a first down.
The halfback with a carry.
Touchdown, and they take the lead.
They got it.
A short three play. Fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it.
Pitches right. He's taken down at the 30.
Huge play for the defense.
Going deep. Lays it out there. And he tackles him hard at the 15.
What is he thinking? The quarterback has got to know at this time in the game, unless his man is wide open, that he should just throw it away. It's these kinds of mistakes that can cost you a game.
Dumps it complete to the halfback over the middle.
He's to the 40. And he's finally shoved out at the 48-yard line. That's a good. Now he tries to buy some time.
He's hit and taken down. And there's a penalty on the play. Let's see who it's on.
Looks to pass. Tackle at the 17.
Back to pass. Had his hands on it and dropped it.
Boy, Brad.
He's looking to pass. He pumps once.
Picked off, and that'll seal it up.
Oh, no. They really didn't need that.
And as a quarterback, you can't give up an interception late in the game. You got to be more careful with the football.
And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. He takes a knee. Penn State will have one timeout remaining. It's second and 12. Ball on their own 35. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock.
You're an offensive coordinator. You love their down.
And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock.
He takes a knee, looking to take some time off that clock. So this one's final. Very well played by both teams today. 28-21, Michigan State. So what are your final thoughts on this one, Kirk?
They've talked about the rivalry all week long, and for good reason. We saw the intensity down on the field every play, and it showed us why these teams love to hate each other. It'll be interesting to see how this game carries over to the next time they play.
EA Sports congratulates this young man for his fine performance and his award for Player of the Game. That's going to wrap up this game of NCAA Football 13. For Kirk Herbstreit, Aaron Andrews, and Reese Davis, Brad Nessler, so long.